You're at 1-55 W Square Lake Road, Bloomfield Hills, Michigan.
Michigan have now heard from two individuals who claim that they were complicit in the kidnapping of Governor Gretchen Whitmer. Kayla Franks of Waterford Township ended the evidence on Friday, confessing that Following his arrest 2 years ago, he had lied to the FBI, telling investigators that the group were merely a bunch of jokers who loved to role play. Frakes pled guilty to conspiracy charges last month and testified against four men this week. Ty Garvin of Heartland Township, who pled guilty as well, said earlier this week that there is no doubt that the gang planned to abduct Whitmer because of her COVID-19 policies and their general disdain for government. The COVID-19 pandemic has been stressful for everyone, but especially for individuals with disabilities and their caregivers. The Michigan Department of Health and Human Services held a town hall Friday to discuss how vulnerable Michiganders have been impacted. Chief Medical Executive for the state of Michigan, Dr. Natasha Bagdasarian, discussed several medications to consider.
Talk to your physician about EmuShell. So that is a monoclonal antibody, long-lasting as a pre-exposure prophylaxis if you are someone who is extremely immunocompromised. And then for those who do get COVID, medications like Paxlovid or monoclonal antibodies that could again reduce your risk of death and severe outcomes.
Bagdasarian added that one of the challenges Michigan has faced during the pandemic is getting those life-saving medications into the hands of those that need them the most. A judge has ruled to allow a religious group to move forward with plans to build a mosque in Troy.
The federal judge has ruled against the city of Troy in a dispute over a mosque. A federal judge says the city's zoning practices treat places of worship worse than any other group. The case started in 2013 when a Muslim organization called Adam Community Center sought approval to open a commercial building for worship services and other activities. The city's zoning board denied the application, and that's when the Justice Department intervened. Troy leaders say that they are looking over the ruling before considering their options. Jackie Page, WWJ News Radio 950.
New information has emerged regarding the inspector's report on the Sturgis, Michigan factory at the focus of a recall of baby formula.
The FDA examination, which concluded last week, discovered that Abbott did not maintain clean surfaces using the production and handling of the powdered mixture. Inspectors also discovered a history of contamination with the bacteria known as Chronobacter, with 8 occurrences happening between the autumn of 2019 and February of this year. It is to blame for a slew of diseases and the deaths of 2 babies. Similac, Alimentum, and L-Care are all manufactured at this facility. WWJNewsRadio.com has more on the recalled formula. I'm Anna Landrum, WWJ News Radio, 950.
What's being done to fix the roads in your neighborhood? In one local community, it just got a little easier to find out.
A new pavement condition dashboard has been made available to residents in Ann Arbor on the city's website. They're using a rating system called PACER, or Pavement Surface Evaluation Rating, to determine the best fix for each road. The system rates each segment on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being the worst condition and 10 being the best condition, meaning new pavement. Residents can head over to the city's website to see what their neighborhood roads are rated and if a fix is in the works. The dashboard includes a visual representation of the condition of major roads and local streets maintained by the city, color-coded to their PACER rating. Dan Jenkins, WWJ News Radio 950.
Coming up in 2 minutes after traffic and weather,
you can get a cat or a dog at a reduced fee at Detroit Animal Care and Control over the next several days. I'm Beth Fisher.
News time 11:08. Time for traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th. Marty Buffalini, we got some problems. How's it looking right now?
It's looking really good. A lot better than it did earlier. The roads have improved from being snowy and wet and a little slippery. Might still be in some spots, maybe where you are. So just keep your eyes peeled. But right now on the AAA jam cams, we have no crashes. A lot of new work zones that have popped up. We've got northbound I-75 from Jefferson to Holbrook as they're moving work crew there in the left lane until noon. Only the right lane is open on eastbound 8 Mile from Woodward to DeQuinder. They're also working there till noon. Southbound I-75 after Dix has the right lane closed until 3 o'clock this afternoon. Westbound I-96 from Novi to Wixom, right lane closed till 4 this afternoon. Now we do have that slow traffic on westbound I-96 where the right lane is closed from Meadowbrook to Beck Road and seeing some slowdowns in that area. Also looks like it's slow southbound Telegraph at Long Lake Road, where only the left lane is open, and you're slow from about Franklin. And your next traffic update coming up at 11:18 from the Capital Mortgage Funding Traffic Center.
How is our AccuWeather forecast?
For today, windy and cold and a taste of winter once again with a few snow showers around. Watch for poor visibility and slick spots on the roads, especially through this morning. Any afternoon snow shower could mix in with some rain at times. Temperatures nearly steady in the 30s. AccuWeather real field temperatures dipping into the 20s. For tonight and tomorrow, a cold stretch of weather, mostly cloudy and brisk. Low tonight of 21, high tomorrow 32. The real field temperatures will be in the single digits early in the day tomorrow. Monday still chilly despite some sunshine, high of just 37 degrees. Tuesday some sunshine giving way to increasingly cloudy skies, high of 40. There could be a wintry mix Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. For the rest of Wednesday, turning milder by the afternoon, though clouds stick around. High 51 for AccuWeather. I'm here all the Matt Benz on WWJ News Radio 950.
In Ann Arbor, we do have flurries reported, currently 32 degrees, winds out of the northwest at 15 miles an hour at Detroit Metro. It is also 35 degrees, a bit windier, winds gusting up to 21 miles an hour. WWJ News Time 1110. Some Ukrainian refugees may be settling in Michigan. According to reports, the U.S. plans to welcome up to 100,000 Ukrainians who have fled their nation during the conflict with Russia. According to a member of the Michigan-Ukrainian-American Crisis Response Committee, she is unsure of how many individuals will come to Michigan, but she says they are prepared. Five or six groups do have the potential to assist the refugees. If you've been holding off on adopting a pet cat or a dog, now may be a good time to do it. There is an emergency Empty the Shelters adoption event happening at Detroit Animal Care Control. It is sponsored by the Bissell Pet Foundation and now through Wednesday. Founder Kathy Bissell says adoptions have slowed up and there's a puppy explosion.
Cost of care and there's a veterinarian shortage. So all of this is compounding, and with larger dogs not getting adopted, this is what's filling up our shelter system.
Bissell says with their sponsorship, you will pay a low adoption fee. Detroit Animal Care and Control, located on Chrysler Drive in Detroit. Ballet is back in Detroit. The American Ballet Theater Studio Company will be performing live tonight at 8 o'clock at the Music Hall Center for the Performing Arts in downtown Detroit. Vince Paul, the center's artistic director, says it is a chance to see professional dancers performing world-class ballet.
You're also going to see like some contemporary works that they don't normally get to take on the road and perform, because when they send out this task force size, you know, there's about 14 dancers in the company. These are their big rising stars, and they're able to do, you know, much more contemporary work from like Twyla Tharp and Lauren Lovett.
Another show is scheduled for tomorrow at 3 o'clock. Additional ballet companies will be performing in April and May. And for more information, you can go to musichall.org. Coming up on WWJ.
If you've ever dreamt of being a car designer, this may be for you. I'm Autobeat reporter Jeff Gilbert.
Well, spring is right around the corner, and you know what that means? It's tournament time! Our Chicken Shack bracket is stacked with all of your familiar top seeds. Juicy chicken, tender ribs, creamy coleslaw, and golden shack potatoes. But you can't count out some of the new underdogs, like our crispy English-style cod or our sweet barbecue wings. And you can't forget about the return of our original hand-dipped chicken bites. They are crispy on the outside and tender on the inside. They really are a contender and a fan favorite. But rest assured, whatever you pick from Chicken Shack will be a winner, because our time-tested recipes have been handed down through the generations. So order online at chickenshack.com, and you don't have to miss a minute of the action, because DoorDash can deliver your favorites right to your door. So this spring, enjoy all the madness and the buzzer beaters, the Cinderellas and the sleepers, and score big by serving Chicken Shack at your tournament parties. Remember, when you think Chicken Shack.
Mike Campbell here, serial entrepreneur with words from another happy customer.
Detroit Software Accounting is amazing. I was able to see where's all my expenses going, where's the revenue, which month had more revenue. I definitely recommend it to you guys who are a small business and need to record your expenses. And they just make it so easy. I was like, wow. Affordable and easy to use. I have recommended it to colleagues.
Easy to learn, easy to use. Small business software tailored just for you.
Visit us at PatriotSoftware.com. That's PatriotSoftware.com.
It's PatriotSoftware.com. Accounting and payroll. Keep your time and money.
There's a whole newsroom inside your smartphone. opened up today in District Detroit. Just say, hey, Alexa, play WWJ 950 and get breaking news live around the clock. Detroit's news, weather, and traffic station. WWJ News Radio 950. Depend on us.
Hi, I'm Dr. Candace Jones with the American Academy of Pediatrics. I know we're all looking forward to getting back to life after the pandemic. That's why now is the time to get your kids caught up on their childhood vaccines, so they'll be protected from things like measles and meningitis when the world starts to open up again. When you call your pediatrician to schedule their checkup, it's a superhero moment. Call your pediatrician today.
AccuWeather meteorologist Matt Benn says it's going to be cold pretty much all weekend, even on Monday by Tuesday. We will see the high near 40 on Tuesday, but then a wintry mix Tuesday night. Right now, we are still seeing flurries in Ann Arbor, 32 degrees. Flurries here in Southfield, currently 34 degrees. WWJ News time, 11:15. It's spring, regardless of the forecast, and for those who suffer from seasonal allergies, this time of year can be especially difficult.
Watery or itchy eyes, sneezing, nasal congestion, or a runny nose can be symptoms of seasonal allergies. Trees are the biggest pollen producers in the spring. Dr. Roy Elrod is an emergency room physician at DMC Detroit Receiving Hospital.
Right now, with climate change, allergists predict that this season may be the most severe we've had in the last 10 years.
Well, over-the-counter medicines like antihistamines and decongestants can help if you're not getting better, or
if you begin to notice that maybe your throat is closing, you're having difficulty breathing, or you're wheezing, there's a chance that it may be something not that's just an allergy that you need to be evaluated and treated for. Come in and let us evaluate you at one of our Detroit Medical Center emergency departments.
From the Delta Dental Health Desk, Dr. Deanna Lights, WWJ News Radio 950.
Stellantis is looking for the vehicle designers of the future.
For 10 years, Fiat Chrysler and now Stellantis has done something called Drive for Design. It's a competition for high school students who love to draw cars. Not that long ago, Ben Trinan was one of those students. He won. Now he designs Ram interiors and is one of the judges.
If this seems like something you might love as a career, you know, drawing cars, this is a perfect opportunity for you. Just enter the competition, get yourself out there, you know, get some exposure to the industry.
More information at StellantisDriveForDesign.com. Jeff Gilbert, WWJ, News Radio 950.
According to Michigan State Police, something peculiar was discovered inside the residence of a suspected auto thief. It was the gadget used to program automobile keys. And last night, that suspect eluded a traffic stop on I-96 near Southfield. Officers observed him later backing into his driveway on Detroit's northwest side. They investigated the house and discovered the programming tool as well as an illegal pistol. The vehicle had been reported stolen from Oak Park, and that suspect being held at the Detroit Detention Center pending charges. Are you interested in learning more about the cannabis industry in Metro Detroit? Well, the Lucky Leaf Expo, which is taking place this weekend, is the place to be.
Huntington Place will host the expo. The conference will provide visitors an inside look into the marijuana industry in Michigan. Expo spokesperson Mark Edwards says there will be lots to experience, including cooking demonstrations.
He will cook with either CBD or hemp, and he'll display his dishes and sometimes even pass them out to the attendees to try on the spot there. So it just gives a little more flavor to the show. You'll be surprised how many cooks cook with cannabis, hemp, and CBD in the industry. They make a lot of infused dishes.
If your interest has been piqued and you want to learn more, visit their website at LuckyLeafExpo.com for more conference information. Arnetta Landrum, WWJ News Radio, 950.
News time, 11:18. Traffic and weather together. Let's hit the roads with Marty Buffalini.
Still looking good on those roadways. We have, well, no crashes, really. We just have a lot of construction that's gone. Looks like the roads are improved, too. And this is brought to you by NECA, IBEW Local 58. We do have some slow traffic in some of those construction areas, so we will make this. The National Electrical Contractors Association, NECA Construction Alert Update. Still looks kind of slow on our AAA jam cams. Westbound I-96, the right lane is closed. Meadowbrook to Beck Road and North. I see some brake lights in the area. Also looking at some slow traffic on southbound Telegraph, where only the left lane is open at Long Lake Road. You're slow from about Franklin. Northbound on southbound I-75 at Newport Road. One lane is closed there until each way until the 31st, this coming Thursday. East to westbound I-96 between Kent Lake Road and 275.